In the previous video, we saw the simple situation where the parent with no surviving spouse and no will leaves an estate that gets divided equally among her surviving children. Now we'll see an illustration of something the probate code calls per capita representation, roughly meaning distribution per person. Here, child one and child three have had children of their own. These are the grandchildren of the person who leaves the estate that we're talking about today. But child one and child three, illustrated by the solid rectangles, have already passed in this example. They have predeceased their parents. Under the probate code, the middle child, child number two, who is still living, inherits her one-third share of the estate. The remaining two-thirds is divided among four grandchildren. They each get 16% shares, one-sixth of the estate. The probate code provides equality among those equally related. Even if grandmother didn't want this result, this is what happens because she didn't leave a valid will. Now look at what happens if child two and child three had survived. Again, there would be the one-third for the middle child, child two, and child three gets his one-third. This time, though, the three surviving children of child one will get less, only 11% each, one-third of the one-third share. In our next videos, we'll see how the order of deaths in the family set up unpredictable results for the survivors. Provide your own specific instructions in a will or trust to avoid the probate code lottery that changes the values of shares that pass to grandchildren. And if you are the personal representative for an estate that is not covered by a will, we can explain how the law has determined the shares of the estate.